Hi friends, welcome to Commoner series. Today we are going to see about the Gandhism and its relevance in the 21st century. Mohandas Karamchand Gandhi is a very popular leader in the 20th century. There are many things which makes Gandhi unique and his principles relevant to this time. Mohandas Karamchand Gandhi is rightly called as the father of our nation because he single-handedly stood up against the mighty British Empire without any arms. So what is Gandhism really meant? When asked about what is your message to the people, he replied that his entire life is a message. Gandhi stood for many principles in his entire life. The main basic principles like Satyagraha, where he propounded it through ahimsa and non-violence, and his emphasis on means rather than ends, and his concept of Swavalambi, which is self-sufficiency, where he emphasized on Om Svang Khadi cloth to for him and his followers, and the principle called Sarvodaya, the universal or progress of all the downtrodden people through trusteeship concept. So what are the problems in today's world? Since independence, country has witnessed many violent communal riots, pogroms, mob lynching acts, corruption scandals, and the rise in inequality between the haves and have-nots, questioning the relevance of Gandhi and his principles today. It is sad that his birthday is celebrated and not his principle every year. So, what is the relevance of Gandhi and his principle in today's consumeristic, materialistic and agnostic culture? Gandhi is a shrewd politician. He, on the one hand, tried for the independence, and on the other hand, he wanted a just and inclusive India. This he emphasized through non-violent, ahimsa and democratic means. In this path, he resembled Buddha, for whom the eightfold path it itself the goal and essence of life. Thus, the Gandhi insisted means rather than ends. Gandhi is a man of practice. As stated earlier, he lived his entire life as a message to every people and his followers. Gandhi emerged as a prophetic voice for 21st century for the non-violent principles. Gandhi is remembered for his utterance of passionate following for non-violence throughout the world. According to Dalai Lama, many ancient masters have preached non-violence and ahimsa as a philosophy, but it is only Gandhi who implemented this noble philosophy in his modern politics and succeeded in it, which is a great thing. Gandhi was a great moral force, and Dr. Martin Luther King said that men should not obey evil and unjust laws. And Gandhi believed that men should happily go to jail for not obeying such evil and unjust laws. This principle is the moral foundation for movements like civil disobedient movements to Montgomery bus boycott, where the racial segregation in US. Gandhi believed in the power of masses. While asking how you are going to face the mighty British Empire, he said, with the help of dumb masses. Ex-president of US Obama commented that Gandhi embodies the transformational change where ordinary people come together to do extraordinary things. According to Gandhi, a true Satyagrahi is fearless and courageous. He faced the fear face to face with unshakable conviction and stood for injustice. Gandhi says, good travels in a snail's pace, but surely it travels. And he emphasized that mere goodness is not of much use. It should be combined with knowledge, conviction and courage. These were the moral foundation for his movements, where he stood for his principle with knowledge and conviction through hunger strikes and with sheer determination. Gandhi demonstrated that non-violence could be an effective instrument for social change in the 21st century. If the 21st century is the century of the common man, then Gandhism has even more relevance in this age. Gandhi has inspired and will continue to inspire many political, social, religious, environmental leaders. from Obama to Dalai Lama. More importantly, Gandhism will be relevant till humanism exists in this world. Thank you.